Imagine that you've hopped onto a red blood cell to tour the heart. You and your blood raft flow into the right atrium from the superior or inferior vena cava, the largest veins in your body. After reaching the right atrium, you have less than half a second to admire the scenery before the atrium contraction sends you down to the right ventricle. To get from the right atrium to the right ventricle, you will have slipped through your tricuspid valve. Heart valves function as perfectly timed doors and only allow blood to move in one direction. After you slide through the first set of valve flaps, they slam shut behind you and the ventricle contract. This sends you shooting upward through the pulmonary valve in the pulmonary artery. The pulmonary artery sends the blood toward the lungs, splitting it into many smaller tubes. You are eventually squeezed through the tiniest tubes into the lungs' alveoli. In these narrow tubes in the lungs, the red blood cells load up with oxygen, and carbon dioxide leaves the blood vessels. Then you and your oxygenated buddies flow back to the heart through the pulmonary veins. One of the pulmonary veins dumps into the left atrium. Soon after you reach the left atrium, a familiar process begins again as the atrium contraction sends you down through the mitral valve and into the final chamber, the left ventricle. From here, you will embark on an adventure through the body because the next ventricular contraction will send you bursting upward into the aorta. The aorta is a large tube that branches into many other smaller tubes to distribute newly oxygenated blood throughout the body. If you decide to continue with the tour, you may flow down to a toe before circling your way back to the heart in roughly 30 seconds. Now that you know how your heart works, it's time to take you on a fascinating tour of the digestive system to show you what happens to the food you eat.